Right, we've all learned a lot lately about how a virus spreads, right? But here's one virus you may not have heard of. The stress virus.
Yes, scientists have discovered that just like other viruses, stress can be catchy.
You can all picture the scenario. You're happily getting on with your day when...
Oh, this is fascinating.
Maddie, I have had the worst morning. I slept through my alarm, my cat threw up on my weighted blanket, then I bit into an apple, it turned out to be a potato. I've just got so much going on right now, it's so annoying.
And studies show that our stress can actually be contagious.
Oh, Zoe, I'm so busy today. I've been reading up on the cricket. James comes along, starts offloading on me, and I don't know what to do, but... Oh, sorry.
Yep, it spreads from human to human, and now they're studying animals to discover how. And one finding is that the mice give off a stress smell. So can we let our friends vent without taking on the burden ourselves?
And clinical psychologist Dougal Sutherland is here now. So great to see you again, Dougal. Is this a real scientific phenomenon? Can stress actually be contagious?
Yeah, look, absolutely. We know that lots of emotions can spread from person to person and from animal to animal. The main ones are stress, sadness, happiness, which is good, and anger a bit too. But yeah, we definitely pick up and spread those emotions around just like any other old virus.
And what happens to someone while they're in the presence of someone who is stressed?
Well, weirdly enough, our brains pretty much do the same thing as the person that's stressed, so it's almost like we mirror in our brains what's going on for that person. And that's probably a really useful thing, because actually it's the filling or the base there for empathy. So if you can feel what somebody else is feeling, it actually helps you develop empathy for them.
I mean, scientists seem to think that mice give off like a stress pheromone. Could that be true in humans as well, Dougal?
Well, you know, I think we can smell lots of things in other humans and in ourselves, but it's not really clear that we give off pheromones, but the science still could be out on that. We're probably more likely to pick up on little behaviours like somebody's facial expressions particularly, because we're well tuned into that, or what they're doing. So maybe we're not picking up on the pheromones sort of thing. We talk about that sometimes, though, like the smell of fear, but whether that's a real smell or not, I'm not quite sure.
You mentioned it before, and I'm guessing it's a positive thing that we can pick up other emotions too, like more positive ones.
Yeah, absolutely. Like a classic experiment that we sometimes do with groups is get people together talking about the word happiness and how many different words you can get, and somebody starts talking about it and they start smiling and laughing, and that ripples around the group. And so it's actually a really nice way of enhancing a positive emotion like happiness. If you share it with somebody else, it tends to snowball. It tends to go and go and go and grow and grow and grow. So that's a really useful thing. And it brings us together, it bonds us together really well as a group.
Dougal, none of us like feeling anxious, so how do you actually avoid catching stress off others?
Well, you might not be able to avoid it. I think the thing would be to notice that what's going on for you, and perhaps be able to just take a moment and figure out, is this actually my anxiety, or am I anxious simply because they're anxious and stressed? And once you've figured that out, you could actually do something really useful. You could go and comfort that person, or help them, or listen to them, or talk to them. So actually, in helping them de-stress, you might help yourself de-stress as well.
Dougal, thank you so much for that. Great advice, as always. Thank you so much. Have a great night.
Thanks, guys. Cheers.